Big guy, trench coat, hat, gun.
Turkey. A pattern's beginning to emerge. It's Clooney, all right.
Not Clooney, Bob, the bogeyman. He really believes he's bogey.
Was it just the girls singing that annoyed him?
Who knows what Looney Tunes this fella hears in his head.
Right. Sorry, folks, this place is closed for tonight.
Home time?
The more I chewed my burger, the more I knew I'd have to go back for Lauren. Sure, I gave McCurdy's goons the slip this time, but they'd be back. Lauren was in danger because of me. I'd given her the money to spread around. Half the town had seen me talking to her. I couldn't just offer her protection. She was too good for that. Maybe if I told her I loved her and wanted to be with her forever. Dames always go for stuff like that. At Tommy Trotter's, there was a big surprise waiting for me. As I eased my way out of the car, a happy thought struck me. Fortunately, I brought my nail clippers along. Okay, so it's Christmas, but I didn't expect the joint to be gift-wrapped. I decided to declare this bar open. Hi.
God, you've got a brass neck, man. This place was hoaching with the fuzz a wee while ago. I wouldn't have thought you'd have been back in a hurry.
Kid surprise is the key to keeping the flat feet on their toes. Tamburlaine. That not the name of a play?
Yeah, Marlowe.
Don't call me Marlowe. Call me Bogey.
Christopher Marlowe, the playwright. You wrote Tamburlaine.
Yeah, I knew that. Must have slipped my mind. So, Songbird flown, eh?
What? Oh, Lauren, you mean? She left a couple of minutes ago. She was heading to Ed's diner, but I wouldn't bother following her. She was really miffed that you ran out in the middle of her number, and the cops closed us down. You won't be her favourite person at the moment.
Yeah, well, it wasn't the singing, it was the song.
Well, too much for you, was it?
No. She didn't let it get to me, but it always does. Got to play it for us, Tammy.
What, now?
Why now? I've got to face it.
I'm all packed up, ready to go.
You're playing it for her, you can play it for me. Tam, play it.
All right, don't shoot me. I'm only the piano player.
Okay, you win. Can't stand it.
Hey, what about this one?
I left the little sadist tinkling the ivories and made the short hike across the street to the diner. They looked like a respectable family concern to me, but who knows in this crazy town. Sorry, sweetheart, it wasn't your singing, it was the song. Kind of guessed to me.
You could have killed somebody back there. You're not exactly Mr. Emotional Stability, are you?
What do you mean? Emotionally, my ship sails on a steady course.
That's not what I see. I see a very leaky boat. One that the police are trying to sink, Mr. Clooney.
Don't call me Clooney.
See what I mean?
Oh, sorry.
Look, Mr. Whatever you like to call yourself, let me be honest with you. Sergeant Ure told me you were crazy. Pure radio rental. That you've escaped from the loony bin. And that they want you back inside pronto.
Well, it's a lie, of course.
Why would they lie?
Well, because they have to have a cover story, don't they? The flat feet don't want anyone to know what's really on the loose in this town.
What is on the loose, apart from you?
The happy gang. The dough from their last heist alone could unravel the fabric of this city. Plowed back into drugs, shady massage parlors, cheap clip joints.
You tell her, big man.
Yeah, exactly.
The happy gangland of this city is their happy hunting ground. We're kids, we've driven to despair and drugs. Exactly. We're honest citizens and be afraid to go out at night because the streets are dark with something other than night.
Gun yourself, big man.
Yeah, and these hoods are going to triumph unless we stop them. Yes, friend.
Yes.
Parsons knows, boss.
Hi, fat man. Long time no see. You call yourself McCurdy now, they tell me. I know the secret of the big bird which makes me happier than you, Mr. Happy. I know where the stuffing is stuffed. For further information, meet me at the highest point in the necropolis at 2 a.m. PTO. Pete, this guy's mental. See you at the Statue of the Angel. You can't miss it. Big girl. Wings. And don't bring your friends. The bogeyman. Get those clowns down here, sharpish.
Where do I fit into all this?
Ever heard of a little item called the Maltese Falcon?
Yeah. Did they not make a film about that?
No. Anyway, I have the Maltese Falcon. And also a couple of suitcases full of other little treasures.
So why are you eating in a crummy dump like this?
Because I want to find out everything I can about the fat man.
Who?
McCurdy.
He's not fat.
Ah, so he's lost a few pounds, has he? Nice move.
What's McCurdy got to do with all this?
He's the fat man. He's Mr. Happy, the brains behind the happy guy.
Right enough. I always thought there was something shady about him. And that snooty, sniffy wife of his.
Well, what's her problem?
She calls herself an aromatherapist. Huh.
Well, she would, wouldn't she? Put you off the scent. Now, what do you say, sweetheart? You've got the kind of eyes a man can trust. I'm giving you the chance to climb on board. What do you say?
Some of the things you say seem to make sense. I suppose you could be on the level. No. I think I should be getting back. I've got an early start tomorrow.
Okay. Is that what you want to do? Want to spend the rest of your life pouring shots in that crummy bar? Or do you want to live a little? Want to go places? Fly with the high rollers? Okay, turn your pretty nose up at it. But it's your loss. And, to tell the truth, I need somebody I can rely on. Where I'm standing, it's a lonely place. Adios.
Walk away, Bogey. There ain't a dame alive can stand it. One, two,
wait.
Three.
I'll help you.
Thanks, kid.